So I was watching Espressif's DevCon where they were having quite different sessions, and I found one common thing in all those sessions, which was they were using a simulation tool for showing the working demo on the ESP32 board. And I was like, wow, this is a great tool for learning and also for educating ESP32 for all those who don't have the hardware with them. Well, I do have used the simulation tool back in my college days, but for 8051 and for Arduino Uno board, but this was quite different as it was using the ESP32 board. Now here I was curious to know what kind of codes will this simulation tool support for ESP32 board. Will it be able to provide the Wi-Fi connectivity for making those real life IoT projects, and whether I'll be able to add the libraries for Blink support, for Rainmaker support and stuff like that. Well, I'm having a lot of caution regarding this tool, and I'm sure you must be having a lot of doubt, a lot of questions in your head. Well, don't worry, in this video I'm gonna solve all your doubts, all your questions, as in this video I'm gonna let you know what is this tool about, how to use it, and what kind of projects we can make using this tool, and is it useful for learning and for educating IoT projects to the people or not. Well, everything will be clear in this video, so sit back and I'll start this video after a short ad. This video is sponsored by Altium, which is a PCB designer based software company. Now Altium is not just another PCB designing software, rather it's a world class and award winning PCB designing tool that has some features like advanced interactive routing with auto completion, any angle routing, bus routing, phase and length tuning, follow me more, and much more, which makes it an ideal choice for PCB designing by a lot of companies. Along with this, they do also have Altium 365 that not just covers the PCB designing part, but also helps with design sharing via web, sharing designs to mechanical team for product design, centralized cloud storage, and a lot more. And along with all this, they do have a very useful search engine made just for electronic components called as Octopart. Using Octopart, you can search for any components and you would be able to compare its price and availability around the globe. Not only that, you can also get the details about the components like its specifications and datasheet all at one single place. So Altium provides everything to make your production task a lot easier. So do try out all these services right now, as you'll be getting a free trial version by just clicking the link mentioned in the description. Happy making. Okay, so this is that tool called as VocVi. So you just need to go to VocVi.com and this will open up and it says simulate IoT projects in your browser. So the tagline itself says that it is made for IoT project that can be run in a browser. So no need to install any external software as well. You can make it work through your laptop, tablet, mobile phone, anything. Okay, so I have already made an account here and I'll recommend you to make an account because this will help you to save your projects here and you can also save other projects as well. Okay, it's free of cost. They do have a paid plan, but I'll let you know what they offer in the paid plans later in this video. Okay, so first of all, they are supporting currently 4 different boards: Arduino, ESP32, STM32, and Pi Pico board. And we can not only program them using Arduino IDE, but it also works with MicroPython. So all your MicroPython related code will work here. Okay, and below that, they do have provided some of the featured projects using ESP32, Arduino, maybe Nano, maybe Uno. So there are a lot of example projects for you. But today in this video, we'll be only exploring ESP32 board. And if you want me to make a detailed video for all of the boards, you can let me know in the comments. Okay, so let's focus on ESP32. So I'll click on ESP32 and here are the featured projects made just for ESP32. Now this projects may be made by some of the community members like me, so I can make a project and upload it onto this platform so that you all people can use it, both hardware and the coding. So with the help of those community members, we are having this kind of projects. Other than that, we are also having the starter template. So this not only supports the ESP32 board, but S2, S3, C3 as well. So it is really up to date, and daily there are, you know, more and more updates coming on in this platform. Okay, and here are a couple of the latest projects submitted by the community member. So let's just start with the starter template to study what kind of interface this simulator offers. So I'll click on ESP32 and here is the blank or the example sketch, example project for ESP32. On the right hand side, we get to see the window where we can attach all the peripherals. So currently we have the ESP32 DevKit V1 board, that same board that we are using the 30-pin development board. Okay, and here if I click on the plus icon, I can see all different peripherals like the LED push button, displays, motors, switch, and there are a lot of peripherals, trust me. So it is enough for making a lot of projects, but enough for learning about IoT, okay? It has breadboard as well, the micro SD card reader, and the list goes on and on, okay? So you can, you know, click on this. So if I click on LED, I can drag and drop it here. I can make the connections, okay? So if I click on this, it will make the connection with the D5. I can change the color of the trackpad, and I can also make the connection of this to the ground. Change its color to black, okay? It's the drag and drop method, quite easy to understand, easy to use as well. So that's how you can add the LED. So I have added the LED at the pin D5, okay? And if I talk about the left hand side windows, and this is the window which looks more or less like the Arduino IDE, and this sketch is written in the form of Arduino IDE only. So we have the setup part and the loop part, and currently we are beginning the serial monitor at 11500 baud rate. Well, these do have a serial monitor built in. So we are just printing hello ESP32 and the loop is blank, okay? So if I click on the play button or start simulation, and here, as you can see, hello ESP32 is written, which was mentioned here. So that was the very first sketch, and that's how you can start using this ESP32, like the virtual ESP32 board, using VocV. Let us explore it more, and let us try to use the LED that we have connected here. Okay, so I'll write as pin mode, and it is connected to the digital pin 5 as output. So it also has the auto fill suggestion kind of thing that we used to see in the latest Arduino IDE version. Okay, now in the loop, what I'll do is I'll write digital write 5 as high. Okay, so here I've written a basic code for blinking LED connected to the digital pin 5, and I also declared it as an output. So I'll click on the stop button, click on start the simulation, and let's just observe if this code works or not. Okay, so it's not working, as I made the wrong connection of the LED. So this also proves that it is completely logical. So it's not like we have connected LED, it will start working. We need to connect it in a proper manner, okay? So I'll disconnect this to the D5 and connect this with the ground. And if I now click on the play button, as you can see, the LED started blinking at the interval of 1 second. So that's how you can get started with using ESP32. But it was a very basic code, and we are able to do this kind of coding in Arduino boards as well, in other simulation tool. So now if this tool can help us with the Wi-Fi related task, well, that will be much more interesting to see, right? Okay, so I'll let you know that. But before that, if you want to save this project, you can click on the save button and give the project the name as LED blink. Okay, and I will click on the save button, and it will be saved inside my project. So if I click here and click on my projects, as you can see, the LED blink project appeared here, and that's how you can use the project and save the projects. Okay, so I'll go to the ESP32, and as you can see here, we have one example code called as Wi-Fi scanning. Now this is the same example, or the built-in example code of Wi-Fi scanning, but now it will be very interesting to see whether this ESP32 board scans my router, like the router nearby in my office, or it scans something else. Let's just try it out. So I'll click on the start simulation button, and let's just wait for the data on the serial monitor. Initializing Wi-Fi, setup done, scanning. It's scanning for the Wi-Fi. Okay, so it found one network, which is VocV-guest, okay? So only one single network. So what happens here is this virtual ESP32 board is not utilizing the Wi-Fi driver of my laptop and scanning the routers. Rather, it is scanning the virtual router provided by this community or the VocV platform itself. And this is not just the router, but if we connect our ESP with this router, it can also provide the internet connectivity as well, which is superb, right? So let's just test it out by making our very own IoT project. So what I did here is I already saved one project, okay? So if I go to my projects and click on Blink ESP32 RGB LED, here is the Blink code which I have written for controlling an RGB LED over internet with the Blink mobile application, okay? So this is that code. Now here is one problem. It is utilizing the Blink library, which is a third party library and not a built-in library in Arduino, okay? So we do have an option for adding a third party library in this VocV platform by just going into the library manager. And here, if you click on the plus icon and just type out Blink, as you can see, here is the Blink library, and I can click on it and library will be automatically added. Similarly, you can add more different libraries. So if I click on ace button library is there. And if I type out as Arduino JSON, let's just see. Okay, Arduino JSON is there. So all the popular libraries which we use for ESP32 and Arduino are available here. And that's how you can install that library. Let's just add the Blink library. So adding the third party library is no issue at all. Okay, so that's how I have included the library, and now I need to provide the Blink related credentials. So I'll quickly open up my Blink account. Okay, so here is that Blink project. I'll quickly copy all these credentials, go back to my Voqui IDE or platform, and I'll paste all the credentials here. And inside the SSID name and password section, you can't write your own Wi-Fi credentials. Make sure you don't write that. You just need to write as Voqui-guest and make the password section as blank, because this is an open network and it will provide the internet connectivity as well. Let us test it out practically. Okay, so that was it about the complete code. I already included the library, and I'll just click on the start simulation button and let us observe it. Okay, and in the code I already used all these three pins on which the LED is connected, and I am using the virtual pin V1, V2 and V3 to control all those three LEDs. So the code is compiling and soon it will get uploaded. Okay, so the code successfully uploaded and it says connecting to Voqui guest. It got connected with the Blink as well, and now I'll turn on my smartphone screen recording and let's just observe it carefully. Okay, so this is the Blink dashboard which I use for my home automation project, but currently I'm using it for controlling the RGB LED. Let's just wait for it. So I'll click on the first button. As you can see, the red LED turned on. I'll click it off. Click on the second. The green one turned on. And the third is for the blue. So I am able to control that LED over internet using my Blink account, which is awesome, right? So I can educate people for making IoT projects with Blink particularly, without taking any hardware at all, or without, you know, asking them to bring their own hardware. They just need their laptop and that's it. They are good to go to make the IoT projects. Yeah, do click the like button. I really loved this concept and I hope you loved it too, and you can show me by just clicking like button right now. So those were the example codes which I used with the Arduino IDE, but the platform also supports MicroPython in it. So let us try out one MicroPython example. Okay, so I already saved one example code. So if I go to my projects and if I go to your likes, okay, so here is the example code written by a community member, which is MicroPython MQTT weather logger. Okay, so it is sending the DHT2 to a temperature humidity value to a MQTT broker using MicroPython. As you can see, this is the MicroPython based code working over internet. So what I'll do is I'll open up my Adafruit IO account and I'll try to send the data to my Adafruit IO dashboard. Okay, so this is my Adafruit IO account, and I'll just copy the username, provide the username here. I'll copy the AIO key, which is nothing but the password, which is pasted here. And the broker is io.adafruit.com. Client ID can be anything. Okay, and I'll be publishing the data to the topic called as temperature. Okay, so that was it about the code, and this will be sending the DHT sensors value. So let's just click on the start the simulation button and let's just wait for the MicroPython code to run on the ESP32 board. Okay, it says connecting to Wi-Fi, connected, and connecting to MQTT server, connected, and it already sent the data. So if I go to the feed section of my Adafruit IO dashboard, okay, so I didn't get any data here. Oh, I forgot, I need to change the topic. So in the Adafruit IO, the topic is written in this format, like username /feeds/ the topic. Okay, so I'll stop it, re-upload it, and let's just wait for it. Connected, connecting to MQTT server, and now it sent the data, and let's just see if the data is received or not. I'll refresh this page. As you can see, we got the data less than a minute ago. So if I open this, here is the data I got on 18th September, which is today. The humidity is 40 and the temperature is 24. Now this data is of course a dummy data, it's not a real data, but it is good for testing about how to use this sensor and how to send its data over internet to the MQTT broker. So that's how you can use any MQTT broker here and make it work on this virtual ESP32 board. Again, truly awesome. Well, after Blink and Adafruit IO, I was curious to know whether this simulation tool will support the ESP Rainmaker code or not. And for that, I just took the example code called as RMaker Custom from ESP Rainmaker examples, and I have pasted that code here. I haven't made any changes yet. And let's just click on the start simulation button and let's see what we are getting. Okay, so it says sketch too big. Okay, so maybe the flash memory of this board is not enough to upload this sketch. But don't worry, this simulation tool has one more feature in which we can change the flash memory of the ESP32 board. Yes, we can modify the flash memory as well. For that, I just took the example code from here. Okay, so this is the ESP flash size example code. And if I upload this code, currently the flash size is of 8 MB. And if we go to the diagram.json file, under the attribute section, if I change the flash size to 16, and if I again upload this code, the size will increase to 16 MB. And that's how you can change the flash memory. So let's try to increase the flash memory to 16 MB and try if this code works or not. So I'll go to the diagram.json, and here under the attributes, I will just copy this and we'll paste that here. Now go to sketch again and click on the stimulate button, but still the same error, sketch too big. So I'm not able to upload the Rainmaker code in the simulation software. So if you have used it already and if you know what's the problem actually, well, do let me know the solution of it down in the comments of the video. Well, this will help me and the community members as well. Okay, so the Rainmaker is not working, but the MQTT is working, the Blink platform is working. Okay, now we all know ESP along with Wi-Fi do have Bluetooth in it. So the question is, can we make the Bluetooth related projects like right now? Well, the answer is no, and it is mentioned in the official documentation page. So if I go to the docs folder, and here if I click on the ESP32 simulator, and if I scroll down, here are the simulation features which are currently available. So if I go under the ESP32 section only, as you can see, the Bluetooth is not at all available right now. What all things are available? Well, everything is mentioned here, like GPIO, PSRM, UART, I2C, I2S is not yet supported. So these all are features which are supported, and some of them are not supported. We may get to see these kind of features in future because they are regularly updating their things. Okay, now here you can see open for voting is mentioned. So what is that? Well, you can vote for this or any other features if you want in the Voqui platform, but the only condition is you need to be a paid subscriber for it. Okay, so they do have a paid subscription plan called as the Voqui Club. And if you join that club, if I click on this join button, what all things or what all features you will get is you can upload custom Arduino libraries. Yes, this is one of the features. So if I go right now into the library manager and click on the plus button, I can't upload the library. Okay, so in case I have made my own custom library, if I want to upload it, I can't do it because I'm using the free version. And if I want to do that, I need to be a paid subscriber. So that's one of the features. ESP32 Wi-Fi with faster and more stable internet connectivity. Well, this is really important. So right now when we tried this IoT based projects, in this video, like while shooting this video, it was getting instantly connected. But when I tried it for very first time, it was not connecting instantly. It was taking a lot of time to connect with the Wi-Fi router. And that's because many of the people at the same time using that same router, and hence we are not getting enough time to, you know, make the connection establishment, because that is divided into all users. So it depends upon the number of users, like your Wi-Fi connectivity, Wi-Fi speed will depend upon how many people are using it at the same time. Okay, so in the free version, you may need to wait for the Wi-Fi connectivity, or you may get the unstable Wi-Fi connectivity. But again, if you are the paid subscriber, you'll get the faster and more stable internet access. You can keep your projects private and unlisted. Currently, if I need to save any project like this one, I need to, you know, publish that project. So let me just show you. So if I click on the save button, I can't do unlisted. Okay, so I can't save my project privately. If I save the project, it will be visible to all the community members. So that is the point which is missing in the free version. And if you want to save it in a private folder, well, you need to get the paid subscription. Then get any feature that you want, which is open for voting. So I can only vote for a particular feature if I am a paid subscriber. Okay, so I can ask for any feature, I can vote for any feature, and that feature will soon come up in this platform. And ultimately, by paying, we'll be supporting this Voqui and will help them to grow. Okay, so the prices start from $7 a month plus taxes. Okay, so that's the paid version. So if you want all these features, well, you can go for the paid version. And if you don't want, well, it is obviously available for free to use, so you can use it. And one more feature that you get in the paid subscription, which is not listed here, but it is listed in this documentation page, which is connect ESP32 Wi-Fi to your local network. So we all know that in our ESP example codes, we do have some of the example code that supports the Wi-Fi web server examples, like the HTTP client example, that all works in a local area network. Okay, and as we have seen, it is working with with only one and only one router, which is Wokwee Guest, and we can't connect our smartphone or laptop to that router. So how can we use the local area network based projects? That's a question, right? Well, for a free user, well, we can't use that feature of connecting to the local area network and local area projects. But if you pay for it, well, you get an access for running the router on your computer, and ultimately you'll be able to make the local area connection establishment, and you'll be able to use the local area network based projects. Again, a premium feature for premium users. So those are the club benefits, and rest of all the thing is available for free of cost. So if you're using it for free, well, there are a lot of things to explore and a lot of things to work with. So you can definitely go and try your hands on with this platform. I'll leave the links in the description. So that was the Wokwee simulation tool for your IoT projects. Well, I personally love this platform, hence I decided to share with you guys. So now you let me know, how was this platform according to you? Is it useful or not? Well, I'm sure it's definitely useful for all the beginners, all the educators personally. Like next time if I go to take or conduct any workshop, I'll definitely prefer this kind of thing in case the students or the audience don't have the hardware with them. Okay. And yeah, this platform is much more than what is discussed in this video, as it also supports the Pi Pico board, the STM32, the Arduino boards, everything. Okay. So if you want me to make a video on all the other boards, well, you can definitely request me in the comment section. If I get many requests for this content, I'll definitely make one for you guys. And yeah, that was it about this video. Do subscribe our channel to see more such interesting content in the field of electronics, IoT and automation. That being said, I am just ending this video here and now. Just wait for my next video. Until then, explore, learn, share with me, Techie SMS.